What's up, guys? Electro here. Welcome back to Construction Sim 2015. We have made a decision. In the last episode, I asked whether or not we were going to go and purchase a new vehicle or we were going to go for the million credit mark. Well, I think... No, we have made a decision. Yes, we have. Yeah, we're going to go for the million credit mark and we're going to save the purchase of a new vehicle until the next episode. There is a reason I'm going to do that, and that is the vehicle that I wanted to go for originally was going to be the large excavator, because that can open up a few more missions for us. However, I think if we were going to do that, we would need the low boy truck. So the next vehicle is likely to be the low boy, because then we can use it to transport the roller over here to any construction site, and we can then use it to purchase the... Well, we don't need it to purchase, I suppose, but we will need it to transport the large excavator when we do purchase that. So, without further ado, we'll just jump straight into the job market again, and we'll order up a new job for our crew to be working on. Definitely done all of them, haven't we? Yep. So yeah, we'll get a new job going for our crew. That's got 5 stages and earns 154. That's not too bad, is it? That's got 4 stages, 140 or 151. That one's got a high-rise apartment building with 6 stages. I think we will do this one because there's a new... Yeah, look, this is the new mod that's come out, which is free for Construction Sim 2015, and it's talking about high-rise apartment buildings. So I'll tell you what, we'll do that in this episode because I think that's going to break us above just about. Yes, it will. That's good. So what's on the task list for this one? Concrete bags, insulation, drain pipes. We haven't done drain pipes yet, have we? Concrete pouring, drywall. There's 11 tasks in that. So yeah, concrete, large bricks, drywall, insulation, concrete again, UC ceilings and turf. So concrete, insulation, drain pipes. We could get all of those 3 in one. That's not an issue. Then we can do some concrete pouring. Then you've got 3 large bricks, 3 drywall, 2 drywall, insulation. The drywall elements, I think, are quite big. So we're probably not going to get all of that in one go. But we can get the first lot easily. 2, 4, yeah, we'll get all that on. So I think we'll do this one ourselves. And we will get another job for our crew. That's 151 with 5 stages. Yes, we'll do that. I wonder if doing it round this way will enable us to constantly go to the right construction site. Well, we'll find out, won't we? Okay, let's get rid of the mouse and we will fly over to the materials trader. And what will happen is I'll catch up with you guys when we arrive over there. Okay, guys, so we are at the materials trader. One thing that happened en route was the guys finished that first stage of that one. So we'll just get them going on the rest. And we'll jump out in a minute. Size down, and we're going to have a chat with our friend. And we need nothing from that one. 2 concrete bags, 2 insulation, and we need 2 drain pipes. Awesome. Again, get rid of the mouse. Drain pipes, are they on the? Yes, they are. So we can easily get stuff like that. Tell you what, I'm not going to use the forklift this time. I'm going to use the. Can use the crane instead and leave the lights on. Probably need them for the crane. Maybe we should have them on, really, shouldn't we, for health and safety. And here we go. So I'm going to go for the pipes first, I think. One. Try and get it as close as we can to the front of this flatbed. Don't think we're going to be able to, because it's just not that possible. They're at an angle as well, aren't they? Hopefully that's not going to cause us too much of an issue. Shouldn't do with four things. We should get them all on this truck. He says. Well, I would have done if that one hadn't have turned ever so slightly. Come on. We might need a little nudge with the forklift or something. We'll find out. We'll find out. No issues, really, is there? We can always use the forklift to correct any mistakes that we've made. Go for the insulation material next. And we can always stack, I suppose, can't we? That's the good thing about this forklift, this flatbed with a crane, is that there aren't really too many issues with not really too many issues with loading things. You can stack stuff on and do a fair amount with it. You can also load stuff on the small trailers. We found that once before, didn't we? So we could, in theory, if we've got loads to pick up, connect the small trailer as well. Don't really want to have to do that on this occasion, because I think we'll get all four on, even though things are a little bit higgledy-piggledy on there. Just like that, really. Probably going to get loud as they're going over the cab to pick this one up. Try not to hit the racking. I'll have to drag these out, as these are going to be fairly heavy. Leave the boom extended, because I think it's going to be a fairly long reach to get these down the end. It's all very messy, isn't it? Oh well. Can't really odds that, or we can, by using the forklift, because that gets things on there relatively neat. Unfortunately, the swinging around on this thing doesn't really help, is it? Probably not going to reach this one, are we? Yes, we will. Only just, though, I think. There might have been another arm to extend, I don't know. So yeah, things are getting relatively exciting on this this game because of a free DLC that they've added. I wonder if part of the cargo is not loaded properly. We're going to have to try and shove that on with the forklift, I think. Pray and hope this works. Oh, crap. Going to work, is it? Insulation materials loaded wrong. See, everything else is on there all right, it's just that damn insulation. Work, is it? I might have to we're gonna have to start moving stuff around. Hasn't worked very well at all. Just that one bag, that one block of insulation. I just need to sort that out. So the guys have done their little bit. Yes, there we go. Messy as hell, but you know what, it'll do. And we'll just do the quick reset because that makes it a little bit easier to do what we need to do. We're all attached, very very messy, but we'll head on over to the construction site, guys. I just need to double check we are going to the right one. We'll get the guys going on the next stage of that one. And we'll check the map to make sure that I think we need to go to this one. Construction site one. Yeah, we've definitely got construction site one. I think he says we will find out, won't we? Let's get in the map. something else. And yeah, I'll catch up with you guys when we arrive, if we arrive at the right one. So see you in a tick. Okay, so we're just approaching the construction site. I think it will be right here. Yeah, here we go. Whether or not this is going to be the entrance, I don't know. Doesn't look like it. I think it's going to be on the main road. Yes, it is. And I think this is the right one because there's nothing built already. Whereas the other one should have some bits done on it. This one hasn't. So, yes, by the looks of it, we are right. I'm not going to frig around with the crane here, like the Hiab, so I'm just going to order the crane in because we've got some stuff to do. Yes, we want to order that. It's going to cost us 3,000. It's not too much of an issue, and we will get going with it. So we'll move the hook down. Lovely, look at that shadow. Always sunny here, isn't it, in wherever the hell we are. Go and get rid of that mouse. Don't want to see that, do you? Would it be easier if I do it this way, wouldn't it? Yeah, it would. Concrete bags first. Get the one that's fallen over. Make sure there's no high wind here, because this would be moving around quite a lot. It's not too bad. I think they're just going down here. The guys have finished the other stage. That's good. And we'll just go and grab the other bag. I'm hoping we are relatively near it, and we're going to swing right over. Look, that'll do. That'll do. Nearly there, nearly there. Oh, we're going to try and put the bags together, I suppose. Don't really want them on top of each other. Pipes or insulation? Let's go for the insulation. So we will just get this bag, if we can swing it down far enough. And we'll lift that up, there we go. Ooh. Drag it over the top of the truck, never mind. One insulation down. We'll go for the second one. we get this number two. A little bit concerned that it seems to be not doing too much in terms of, maybe there's a lot in the first stage, I don't know. Maybe I've read that wrong, but I'm not moving the progress bar very far, are we? Hitting the truck, that's not good. Yeah, so this isn't gonna do too much damage to the progress bar there. However, these are the bits we needed to do. So we get into the drain pipes. And there's the last one. What does that look like with it attached? Probably quite a good screenshot. What do you guys reckon? Not too bad, is it? It's not an ugly game. Anyway, enough messing around with that. Last one. Nowhere near going to be the... Oh. Ah, hang on. Yeah, the progress bar's different to that because the other mission is sort of showing the bits that they need to do, isn't it? Yeah, that's what it is. Get the guys working on that. Is all well and good, that's brilliant. We will need the, where is that bucket? I need that bucket. Company, we've got warehouse, where is it? Yes, we do want to reset it to the company premises. So what have we got left to do on this then? We need pouring concrete, then we're going to get bricks and drywall elements. So three large bricks, three drywall elements. Two drywall, two insulation, concrete and U seedling and turf. So next job will be to pour the concrete again. Reverse this up, so a block of flats is taking shape already. It's good. What's not good is smashing into the barriers. And we'll head on back to, I need to go to the company premises first. So we need to go the home depot, and then we, yes, we do. So I'll catch up with you guys when we're at the home depot. We'll load on the concrete bucket for the crane, and then we'll drive back. We'll leave our truck at the, oh, we're going to smash into that. We'll leave the truck at the
construction site and we will go and grab the half pipe truck. And it will actually, we'll fly back to the construction site, the home base, sorry, because there is, no, I don't want to go to the building material trailer, I want to go to the home base. That doesn't cost us anything, that's all right. However, we need that bucket thing, so where is that? Quick scoot round and make sure it's not here. Doesn't look like it. Wonder if it's this side. Yes, it is. Deploy our outriggers, we'll grab this bucket. Take this down to the site. It's quite good that once you've bought one of these from the materials trader, it can just reset to your home depot. I know I can reset that, but it's just as easy to do that. Right, it was a bit of a mission to do that, wasn't it? Okay, so we can take this back to the construction site. We need to strap that on first, and then we can get moving. Really know what that noise is ticking for. Anyway, construction site we need to go to. I'll catch up with you guys there. What I'll probably do is catch up with you fully once we've got this back to the site and we have our concrete mixer there as well. So I'll see you guys in a jiff. Pop this here for a minute. Let's get in the crane and lift up the bucket. Don't want to think about purchasing a new vehicle just yet. I'll grab this bucket thing. Try not to smash it into the truck as we do that. And then if I can, it'll probably be easier just to put it down right behind this. And then I can just pick it up again. And actually, we probably don't need to disconnect it either. Because we can just swing this round. And... oh, the outlet camera. Is it? Oh well, never mind. We need to drop the bucket. Okay, let's try that again. Might be because we're on a slope. Yeah, I think it is. Mind you, that would do 68% concrete in that, so should start filling up. Yeah, there we go. Looks like it's full. Oh no, 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 no. Okay, we need to get the guys going on the last stage. Yes. And then we can go and get back in the crane. And pour some concrete. This is probably going to be a little bit more difficult than before. That didn't work, and I'm surprised that stayed stood up. There we go. Is that going into the wall form? Ah, it is now. Yeah, this is a lot more difficult than when you use the pump. However, you could just leave it running because it doesn't seem to run out when it's not actually going in the wall. Yes, it's a little bit trickier than with the actual pump. I think what I might do is get rid of this bucket of concrete, and then we might look at using the concrete pump. How much have we done? 15%. We should do things in order, I suppose. Let's try and get some in here. Okay, that gave us 131,000 no XP, because that's what the guy's doing their bit. So 961,000 guys, we're nearly there. This build is definitely going to take us over. Still only use 98%, or 2% of that was used. It's not going very smoothly. Doing in terms of a percentage now. I can see that. We're not getting any emission going at the minute, that's fine. Wrong way. Still only on 97%, so not doing too bad, but this is taking some time, isn't it? So what I might do, guys, you get the gist of what we're doing, is speed the video up from this point on so we can get moving in terms of the rest of the build. I think if we do another floor like this, then we're going to have to use the concrete pump. It's a big old build though, isn't it? Look at the size of this. In theory, this should fill up that wall and that one. It is ever so slightly. Wrong way. Wrong way again. Difficult doing this backwards. Ah, good work so far. Do you want to continue pouring concrete? No, we don't, because we are happily done. So, otherwise we are going to be here all day, aren't we, doing concrete pouring. See this change, so that's why I've changed the view round ever so slightly. Okay, so the next step will be to clear the construction area from. Okay, that's fine. I need financial statements out. That's good. We need to reverse this up. Achievement unlocked. A million. Oh, we've got a million in our account. That. We will need concrete again at some point, so I will probably stick this other side of the road. We'll need that again at some point in the future, certainly for this build. How are we doing? What changed? Let's have a look. Clearly something's gone on the top. Yes, it has. Okay, so we're going to have to start lifting some stuff right up over there. And that will be some bricks and some drywall elements. And then we are halfway through this build, I think, aren't we? Nearly. Three bricks, three drywall elements. We're nearly halfway through. So what I will do is I'll go and do this little bit, and then I think that will be enough for this episode. This build's going to have to be split across two builds, I reckon. Back to the materials trader in the city, yes. And we need bricks and drywall elements. Yeah, it's going to have to be split between two episodes, otherwise it's going to be taking far too long. And drywall elements. We'll jump back in, and I'm going to use the forklift this time. The last time was pretty messy, wasn't it? Pretty messy. Okay. High ones first, shall we? Ooh. Pop that one up straight away. Large bricks are clearly a lot heavier than their smaller counterparts, definitely. I love how it's quieter in the camp. In reality, this probably should be the quietest view when you're looking at whatever it is you're picking up. They're clearly made of sponge. We'll grab that in a minute. Grab the last bricks, and then I think what we'll do is put the drywall elements on the other side of the truck. That doesn't balance the load very well. Messy as hell, but probably will be fine. Get the last one of these. Sorry. Because those bricks aren't on properly, that's what the problem is. Oh, don't. Well, I said that the forklift puts things on a little bit neater. It clearly doesn't, does it? Well, not when I'm driving it anyway. Okay, that's not going to work. Have to do this instead. Get the last one on. And now this won't reach, will it? No. Great. Set it. Yes. I forgot that you can reset the cargo, can't you? So that should work now. Got to get the angle to pick it up. There we go. Wow, that was a mission and a half to get those bits on, wasn't it? Okay. Back to the construction site. I'll see you guys there in a tick. Okay, we're just about to arrive back at the construction site. We've got a very, very heavy truck full of goods. And I'm going to try and drive it around here. So we don't have to move too far. And we're going to jump in the crane. This will be the last thing we're going to do. It's going to be a split mission. And then we'll finish this bigger build in part two. This will be the first sort of biggest high rise we've done. Bricks just going down. Fairly slow at moving, isn't it, this crane, but it's so much easier than the Hiab. I don't think we'd get the Hiab all the way up there anyway. It's a bit too low for the building. Come on. So one more bricks, and then we got the three insulation materials. We'll probably have to move the large truck. Or the flatbed with a crane. Before we entertain, or before the stage is complete, I reckon. Okay, so that's our three bricks. Just do our drywall stuff. First of the drywall's going in. Second one grabbed, we're just going to go and send this one over. Do that in the cockpit cam. It's fairly cool, isn't it? You just can't see where you're picking stuff up from, or at least I can't. Okay, last drywall element being picked up. And we'll just pop it down in this corner over here. And I think, yeah, we're going to have to move the, can't jump over that, can I? We're going to have to move the truck, because that's in the way. Okay, so we're up another level, and we've got some more bits and pieces we need to go and do. I'll just park this up over here. So, not doing too bad. Are we? So yeah, we've got, what's that, four stories now? And what have we got left to do? We've got to get some drywall elements, insulation, a bit more concreting, and then we've got some new seedlings and some turf. We reached our goal, which is 100, well, we're on now 1,037,000 credits. So that's really, really good. We achieved the goal that we said we were going to in the last episode. Unfortunately, this episode is going to have to be split into two because it's such a high rise, which is good. I think this might be something to do with the new mod that Construction Sim 2015 has released recently. However, this will be the end of this episode. I will catch up with you guys next time when we will complete this build. By going and getting a few more bits from the construction site, or from the materials trader. We'll be bringing them back here. We'll do a bit more concrete pouring use this lovely tower crane, and then we will probably finish off at the vehicle dealership and decide on what we're going to buy. I think we'll probably go for a couple of vehicles, but the first one will be the low boy, and then maybe we'll look at the large excavator so we can start doing some of those missions. As always, guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to rate, comment or subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Construction Sim 2015. Take care. Bye for now.